So what would you do if almost $500 million made its way into your bank account? That is what is at stake in tonight's Powerball drawing. Right now, officials put the estimated total jackpot at $485 million. Now, you can check my math if you want, but by my calculation, that's 15 million shy of a half billion. And given the number of tickets that may be sold today, the jackpot could end up even closer to a total of 500 million. All that money leads to a whole lot of new lottery players and attracts some of us who aren't exactly new to this legal numbers racket. Yep, I called it a racket because that's what it is. Here are the cold, hard, astronomical odds. The chances of having all six matching numbers are 1 in 175,223,510. And yet the notion that somehow those six special numbers would appear on a ticket you hold is intriguing, inviting, and for a whole lot of us, overwhelming. For me, a couple of family members weighed in. First, my dear old dad with a phone call from North Carolina, and then my sweet, lovely, wonderful wife. In both instances, the message was the same. Don't forget to buy a Powerball ticket. If I'm not mistaken, residents of 44 states can now play Powerball, which makes it our de facto national lottery. Years ago, no less a prominent political figure than Newt Gingrich championed the notion of a real national lottery, or lotteries. I recall a speech the former House Speaker made at a Goldwater Institute luncheon back in 2008. Newt called the concept of the lottery, called it out for what it is, an exciting, glamorous form of voluntary taxation. Gingrich theorized that an annual national lottery would be the ultimate shared event, something like the Super Bowl, but the interest would rise by an exponential level since most of us would be playing. And even though the payout to lucky winners would be huge, it wouldn't be as much money as that which would come into Uncle Sam's coffers. And if that dough was designated for national debt retirement, well, the notion of civic virtue might supplant the impulse of personal vice. It's an intriguing concept, but currently it takes a backseat to what's up for grabs tonight. And while we wait and hope and dream, consider the case of a big Powerball winner from 2 years ago, a winner who lived in the congressional district I used to represent in Arizona. Here's the way the story was reported by Ryan Owens of ABC News.
Meet Matt Good, as in good luck, good fortune, and according to his close friends, a good guy.
Just a very personable, nice guy. I mean, he's always out there trying to help somebody.
The 37-year-old works as a manager at an electronics company and says he'll keep his job for now. He lives with his wife and young daughter in this home in a well-to-do suburb of Phoenix.
They're just fabulous. Fabulous people.
Lottery officials say Good did exactly what someone who just won $192 million should. He hired a team of attorneys and financial advisors and then disappeared from the public eye.
We have an Arizona winner.
Arizona lottery bigwigs held a news conference last week, but state law didn't require him to attend, so he didn't, and issued this statement. We are extremely grateful and feel fortunate to now have an increased ability to support our charities and causes. Good is taking the cash option now, telling lottery officials he's worried his taxes will go up even more if the politicians bickering in D.C. push the country over the fiscal cliff. He'll be fine either way.
And any way you look at it, it all comes down to taxes. While tax policy may have forced Matt Good into the public eye in late 2012, Arizona is out to change policies that lift the cloak of anonymity on lottery winners. ABC News and other media outlets discovered Good's identity through public documents, and the Arizona legislature has made it a public priority to shield the names of future lottery winners in the Grand Canyon State. But while Arizona offers the prospect of anonymity, Matt Good has apparently made it a reality. A cursory check for follow-up stories in his name reveals nothing, which is, I'm sure, the way Mr. Good wants it. So while you dream of winning the Powerball, be prepared to live like you're part of a witness protection program or maybe a winner's protection program. That's the way I see it.